When a person is under stress, the system that is responsible to overcome the stress rests with the adrenal glands. However, some people do feel their sense of adrenaline rush when they are under stress. How has this come about? This is Dr. Lam, founder of drlam.com, and in this video, we're going to go through some of the mechanisms of what causes these adrenaline rushes. Symptoms of adrenaline rushes is almost like a flush of hot circulation that's going through your heart, heart pounding. Sometimes the heart can beat fast. You're on an alert state. These are all results of a hormone called adrenaline or epinephrine. It is released as a result of the hypothalamic, pituitary, adrenal axis being overly activated and the adrenals go into overdrive. Now, let us examine what happens when the body is under stress. First of all, the adrenal glands respond by increasing cortisol production as an anti-stress hormone. If this works, then the stress is reduced and you come back down to normal and you don't feel a thing. That is normal. And that's why most people under stress, except as when it is very chronic or very acute, really feel no difference. Life goes on. Now, if the body is unable to handle the stress for whatever reason, and the stress can be physical or emotional, then the body's adrenal system goes into overdrive and produces more cortisol. But this has certain limitations. And when this method is exhausted, then the only thing left is for the body to activate the sympathetic nervous system to open up the fight or flight response and releasing adrenaline. Adrenaline is the only hormone in the body that has no opposing hormone. So once it comes out, it has to be naturally degraded. There's no opposing hormones to offset it or to neutralize it or to reduce the significance of it. And that's why the body is very careful in releasing this hormone. It's perhaps one of the strongest hormones in the world. So over-release of adrenaline can actually kill you. But the body is very smart. It has a way to turn itself off in certain respect. But at the same time, it wants you to have more when you are in danger. So adrenaline is designed to be what we call a positive feedback loop. The more adrenaline is in the system, the more it will release. It is very different from the negative feedback loop, like a thermostat in your home, that once you have too much, the body will shut off. The body does not want to shut off because when you have more need for adrenaline, the body thinks that you are in more danger, so the more you need. So for some people in adrenal fatigue, what happens is that they have a very sensitive reaction. Once the adrenaline is released, it tends to flood out of the system and you get a spike. So this sudden, massive release of adrenaline from the adrenal medulla is what we call an adrenal rush. And usually it does not come up, but it will come up from time to time, especially when you're under stress. And once it comes out, then you feel this sense of warmth, a sense of nervousness, a sense of being super alert. You cannot sleep. Your heart may be palpitating. And these sometimes can happen in the middle of the night and wake you up as well. As well, it can also come on during the day when you're under severe stress. And what do you need to do is sometimes you have perspiration as well along with this. So recognizing that adrenaline rush or adrenal rush is a mechanism of the adrenaline causing the adrenals to produce this hormone is an important component in your understanding of the full adrenal fatigue picture. If you do have these experiences, you have to look and say, what is really going on in your body? How is it really handling stress overall? And what are you doing to prevent this from happening again? Because too much adrenaline rush can destroy your body very quickly. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I have written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571-1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.